So we've already shown that if same side interior angles are supplementary, then the lines that the transversal crosses are parallel. So let's take a look at some of the other angle types. Here I'm showing two same side interior angles, angle D and angle E. One's 54, one's 20, 126. So these angles are supplementary, which means that line M is parallel to line N by the converse of the same side interior angle theorem. See, they're both in between the parallels, so they're inside, and they're on the same side of the transversal. Okay, so now we're going to find the measures of all the angles using vertical angle and linear pair relationships. So, for example, 54 goes to 54. And then I can also say that 126 and 54 goes together because that's a linear pair. And then vertical angle, that gives me 54, another vertical angle, linear pair here, and vertical angle that way. I could say linear pair. There's actually many different ways to get those numbers. So now I'm going to shade in all of the angles that are 54 degrees. There they are. And one thing that's interesting, besides the vertical angles, what other angle pairs are congruent? Well, I can see that D is congruent to H and B is congruent to F. Not only that, if I compare the non-shaded, A is congruent to E and C is congruent to G. So basically, using what we discussed before, we get the converse of the corresponding angle postulate. Now, I probably could have gotten this another way by showing that they have to, if the angles are the same, the lines have to be parallel. Again, this is a postulate, not a theorem, so it is accepted as fact. What about alternate interior angle pairs? So you can look that angle D and angle F are congruent, as are angle C and E. So C and E, we have 126. Angle D and F, we have 54. So we see that when these angles are congruent, the lines are going to be parallel. So if these angles, alternate interior angles, are congruent, then the lines are parallel. What about the alternate exterior angles? So looking at angle A, that goes with angle G, so those are congruent. And angle B goes with angle H, those are congruent. And we see if the angles are congruent, the alternate exterior angles, then the lines are parallel. This is the converse of the alternate exterior angle theorem. And again, theorem doesn't mean it's iffy. It means that it's not as obvious as a postulate. We actually have to go and show it. All right, so in this example, I want to name the theorem or postulate that proves that lines U and T are parallel. Well, you can see here that the two angles that we have that are 105, it's this angle right here and this angle right here. They're on opposite sides of the transversal, so they're an alternate pair. They're in between the two lines crossed by the transversal, so they're interior. My alternate interior angles are the same size, they're congruent, so the lines are parallel by the converse of the alternate interior angle theorem. In this example, I can see that I have two angles, 108 degrees and 108 degrees. So let's see where these angles are. It may help you to color these in so you can make it obvious what the relationship is. So there are my two angles, right? And if I change color, I'm going to go ahead and do a different color so you can see the transversal right there. They're on the same side of the transversal. So I'm probably dealing with either corresponding angles or the same side, one of the same side, interior or exterior. They're not both interior, and they're not both exterior. They're actually corresponding angles, and they're congruent. So that means U and T are parallel because through the converse of the corresponding angle postulate. In my last example for this page, I have 51 degrees on both of these angles. So again, I'm going to look at what kind of angle pair this is. So I'm going to highlight it right here. There's that angle. And then I've got my 51 degrees here. What kind of pair is that? Well, let me go ahead and mark my transversal. They're on alternate sides of the transversal. All right. And they're both outside of the two lines that are crossed by the transversal. So I would say that these are alternate exterior angles. So these two lines are parallel by the converse of alternate exterior angle theorem. When we prove lines are parallel, we use the converse. If we're proving angles are congruent or supplementary, we're not using the converse. We already know the lines are parallel. So for further reflection, which congruent angle pairs can you use to prove that two lines are parallel?